this for years, and you guys paid very close attention. What you learned in this show actually might help save your life.
Where are you going?
I'm a
social distancing.
Alright,
let's see. This is how you walk your dog in Florida.
Hi, neighbor, your cat's missing?
That's weird. Alright, we'll go for it. Alright, what's worse that can happen?
Hi. We landed on him.
Yeah, now what?
I don't know. I don't normally make it this far. Mark, is this the alligator you want? You better say yes, kid. Alright, let's see. We'll catch you out of the teeth. That's not a good spot to start, right? There you go. Now we got ourselves an alligator.
Yeah!
Logan out here, and Logan was telling you guys all a great history about alligator wrangling and how it got started in Florida, right? But Logan didn't have the time to tell you guys breath for about 2 hours under the water. It's a crazy amount of time. You never know when or where this alligator might pop up next. Now, let's say this alligator smells something that it does like a person. The next thing that pops out, like a turtle or a bird, right? The next thing that pops out of the water are the eyes. And a lot of people think that an alligator's eyes are in a really bad spot. So right on top of the head, right? They think that they can get clawed out by an animal, poked out by a... Both eyes, backwards, forwards! Kids, it's a lot of fun. Try it on each other. Kidding, don't do that. You guys are probably wondering, though, what do I do if an alligator's biting me, right? Google says stick him in the eyes. I just told you guys not to. Sounds kind of weird, but you want to make a fist and hit him right in the snout. The reason that works is because the face and the snout are covered in sensory organs. It makes it the most sensitive part on the entire animal. In fact, it's even more sensitive than the millennials nowadays. See, I'll give it a couple shots. It'll let you go. It works on millennials. Not bad, not bad. Someone behind me sounds like a dying chihuahua. We'll talk about it later. But I'm looking around, and man, y'all look thrilled at this so far. I have one more question for you guys. What's the most dangerous part of an alligator? I heard a lot of mouth, teeth, and tail. Logan said feelings. We're going to put it to a vote, because this is America. If you guys think it's the mouth or the teeth, raise your hand. All right, not too bad. If you guys think it's the tail, raise your hand. All right, so all my people who have your hands up for tail, I want you guys to take a really good look at which end I'm holding on to. It's the mouth, guys, come on! When's the last time you turned on the news and heard man in Florida beat dead by alligator tail today? I'm not gonna check. That's called an epiglottis. And if you bite something under the water, it actually seals up the back of the throat and prevents water from drowning them. Dental plan, right? They go through somewhere between 2,000 and 3,000 teeth over their lifetime. The reason they lose so many teeth is because they're constantly biting down really hard things like turtle shells and bones, other alligators. In fact, an alligator at this size already has about 1,000 pounds of crushing force per square inch of their jaw. More than a great white shark or a full-grown African lion. Logan, I think I just peed a little. It's funny from out there. Alright, that's enough of the mouth. If you guys didn't see it that time, the next show is later. Someone else can show you. As you guys just saw, they have a lot of slamming force, right?
Alright guys, give it up for Evan.